In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite PreAlgebra free worksheet naming decimal places. Our directions are to write the name of each decimal place indicated. So let's get started with number 1. And the way to name a decimal place is to start at the decimal point. Although in this instance, our decimal point is at the far right. But 1 to the left is the ones place, then the tens place, then the hundredths place. So because the 5 is underlined, this is the ones place. In number 2, we have the number 7823. Our decimal place comes after the whole number. Because it's not included in the problem, I'll just simply draw it in so we can visualize it. To the left of that decimal is our ones place. So our answer in number 2 is ones. So it goes ones, tens, hundreds, after the comma, then comes thousands. Let's move on to number 3. And number 3, again, our number does not include a decimal point, but we know in order to visualize it, it comes after the 9 all the way to the right. So directly to the left of that decimal place is our ones place, then tens, then hundreds. So the 9 underlined represents, again, the ones place. Now for number 4. In number 4, we have the number 11,717,555. So starting from the right, we have the ones place, tens place, hundreds place, thousands place, and then this 1 represents the 10 thousands place. And then from the 10 thousands, we have the 100 thousands, and then millions and 10 millions. But in number 4, we're at the 10 thousands place. Moving on to number 5, we have 9,053,496. So, 6 is in the ones place, 9 is in the tens place, our 4 is in the hundreds place. Moving past the 4, we have 3, which is the thousands, 5 is in the 10,000s, 0 is in the 100,000s, and 9 is in the millions place. And number 6, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s. 5 is in the 10,000s place. And the way you would read this number is 709,758,968. In number 7, we have the number 105,016. So directly to the left of our comma, we know is the thousands place. So we're at thousands. So this comma, you can think, separates the ones, tens, and hundreds from the thousands, ten thousands, and hundred thousands. And if there was another comma and another number, that comma would separate the thousands numbers from the millions. And number 8, 43,105. The 0 represents the tens place. Ones, tens, then hundreds. In number 9, we have a decimal. Now, to the left of the decimal, like I mentioned earlier, is our ones place. To the right of our decimal, that's our tenths with a th, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths, and then hundred thousandths. So you can think of it almost as going to the right, but as opposed to thousands with an s, we're doing thousandths with a ths. So again, that's tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths. The 10,000th place. In number 10, again, we have another decimal. So that 9 represents our ones place. And then to the right of that decimal, we have the tenths, hundredths, then the thousandths place, and then 10,000ths. So that 5 represents the thousandths place. And again, that's thousandths with a TH. And number 11, again, we have another decimal. To the right of that decimal is our tenths place, and then 2 to the right would be our hundredths place. So the 7 is in the hundredths position. Moving on to number 12, again, we have another decimal. So to the right, because that's where our number is underlined, we have the tenths, hundredths, thousandths, 10,000ths place. So let's continue on to the second page. For number 13, again, dealing with the decimal, and our place value that we're looking for is to the right. So tenths, hundredths, thousandths, 10,000ths. So again, we're at the 10,000ths place. And remember, that's thousandths with a THS because we're to the right of the decimal. We're one place to the right of the decimal, and that would be the tenths place. For 15, 2 represents the ones place, and then to the right of the decimal, 7 is in the tenths place, and 4 is in the hundredths place. Two sits just to the right of that decimal point, therefore that is the tenths place. For number 17, we're still looking at a number to the right of our decimal point. So again, tenths, hundredths, thousandths, 10,000ths. Here we have 100,000ths. So 9 is in the 100,000ths place. For number 18, we have the number 6,721.86. You can see the 1 is what is underlined, and that represents our ones place because now we're to the left of that decimal. So the ones place. For 19, we have the number 69,042,020. There are 3 different zeros, but the underlined zero represents the 100,000ths place. And again, because we're to the left of the decimal, we do not need a hyphen between 100 and 1,000, and also we have DS as opposed to THS. So we know for 100,000ths, we're talking about a number to the left of our decimal point. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000ths, 100,000ths. For number 20, we have the number 9.69. The underlined number is to the right of our decimal place, so we know we're going to deal with something ending in THS, and that is our tenths place. For number 21, we have the number 537,225.88. The 2 is underlined and is to the left of the decimal, so we know we're going to have a number ending in DS. To the left of the decimal is our ones place, then tens, then hundreds. So the 2 that's underlined represents the hundreds place. In number 22, again, we have hundreds underlined. 469,523.77. For number 23, we have a new arrangement of commas, and you can see it's a total of 3 commas. Here is hundreds, tens, and ones, 100,000, 10,000, 1,000, 100 million, 10 million, million. That 3 all the way to the left represents the billion place. However, the underlined 3 is in that millions section, and that is 100 millions. And again, in 23, You can see we're to the left of that comma, and there's a total of two commas. So we're going to be dealing with the millions. So here we have the millions, 10 millions, and 100 millions. So that's 6, just like in number 23, represents the 100 millions place. And with that, we wrap up this free CUDA Software Infinite Pre-Algebra worksheet. If you're having trouble with this worksheet, I recommend practicing, going through and underlining different numbers, testing yourself, and then rechecking. Also, I find it very helpful to say the number every time just so you get familiar with how a number is supposed to be read. Also remember, to the right of that decimal point, we're going to have the indicated places being represented with a word ending in THS. To the left, that word is going to end in just an S, sometimes a DS, for example, thousands, hundreds, although it could just end in an S, such as millions, ones, and tens. So again, it's just important to note that to the left of the decimal place, we're going to end in S, and to the right, those placeholder names are going to end in THS. So remembering that, if I just told you to find the thousands place, thousands with an S, you would know automatically it's to the left of the decimal point. If I asked you to find the hundred thousandths place with a THS, you would know that it's going to be to the right of that decimal point. So that's just a helpful hint for labeling numbers. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.